弟兄姐妹平安。
Peace be with you, brothers and sisters.
感谢上帝。
We thank God.
让我们有生命气息，还有健康的身体，能够来敬拜他。
For giving us a breath of life and a healthy body to come and worship Him.
这是一件何等感恩的事情。
What a grateful thing it is.
我们今天的崇拜是奉圣父、圣子、圣灵的名。
The service today is in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. 我们要赞美上帝。
We want to praise our Lord.
因为每一天他都爱我们。
For He loves us every day.
每一天他都帮助我们。
He helps us every day.
每一天他都祝福我们。
He blesses us every day.
而且每时每刻他都与我们同在。
And He is with us all the time.
我们要将一切尊贵、荣耀、颂赞都归给他。
We want to bring unto Him all glories, all exaltations, and all worship.
God, from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy.
弟兄姐妹
，Dear brothers and sisters，
人生有太多的变化。
There are so many changes, so many uncertainties in our life.
有许多事情我们都掌控不了。
So many things are out of our control.
但是我们知道我们的主他掌管明天。
And yet we know that tomorrow is in our God's hand.
这是我们最大的盼望。
This is our greatest hope.
知明天的道路，每一天只为烛火，我不见明天的太阳，因明天或许阴暗，将来忧虑，因我心主的应许，我今天要与主同行，因他知千年如何，有许多事情，我现在不能视同，但我知谁掌管明天，我也知谁牵我手，我不知明天将如何，或遭遇生活苦楚，但那位羊或麻雀者，他必然也看顾我，他是经过水火之灾，但救主必与我同在，他宝血把我遮盖，有许多未来的事情，我现在不能视同，但我知谁掌管明天，我也知谁牵我手，但我知谁掌管明天，知谁牵我手。
我们同心祷告。
Let us pray in one heart.
主耶稣，我们感谢你。
Lord Jesus, we give thanks to you.
你把光明带进我们这黑暗的世界里。
You have brought light unto our dark world.
让我们看见盼望。
So that we may see hope.
在这面对充满未知的明天，
While we're facing uncertainty tomorrow,
我们依然相信主你掌管一切。
We still believe that God, everything is under your control.
因为这个世界是属于你的。
For this world belongs to you.
而我们也是属于你的。
And we also belong to you.
能够成为你的儿女，真的是何等大的恩典。
What a great grace it is for us to be your children.
我们感谢赞美你。
We give you thanks. We praise you.
愿一切荣耀颂赞都归于你。
May all glories, may all praises be unto you.
愿你悦纳我们献上的赞美。
May you be pleased with our worship today.
奉主耶稣基督的名祷告。
In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen. 今天的经文是取自出埃及记17:1-7.
The scripture for today is taken from the book of Exodus, chapter 17, verse 1-7.
出埃及记十七章一至七节。
The book of Exodus, chapter 17, verse 1-7.
以色列全会众都遵耶和华的吩咐，按着战口从逊的旷野往前行，在利非定安营。百姓没有水喝，所以与摩西争闹说，给我们水喝吧。摩西对他们说，你们为什么与我争闹，为什么试探耶和华呢？百姓在那里甚渴，要喝水，就向摩西发怨言说，你为什么将我们从埃及领出来，使我们和我们的儿女并牲畜都渴死呢？摩西就呼求耶和华说，我向这百姓怎么样行呢？他们几乎要拿石头打死我。耶和华对摩西说，你手里拿着你先前击打河水的杖，带领以色列的几个长老从百姓面前走过去，我必在河列的磐石那里站在你面前，你要击打磐石，从磐石里必有水流出来，使百姓可以喝。摩西就在以色列的长老眼前这样行了。他给那地方起名叫玛撒，就是试探的意思，又叫米利巴，就是争闹的意思。因以色列人争闹，又因他们试探耶和华说，耶和华在我们中间，不是。
这是上帝的道。
This is the word of God.
感谢主上帝。我们同心祷告。
Let us pray in one heart.
主，每个星期我们来到你的面前。
Lord, as we come before you every week.
求你赐给我们有一颗渴慕你的心。
May you grant us a heart that yearns for you.
打开我们的耳朵来聆听你的话语。
Open up our ears to listen to your word.
也有主你的圣灵来光照我们。
May your Holy Spirit come and shine upon us.
帮助我们。
Help us.
改变我们的生命。
And transform our lives.
我们这样子祷告，奉主耶稣基督的名。
We pray this in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen. 小蜗牛问妈妈。
A little snail asked its mother.
妈妈，为什么我们每一天都要背那么重那么大的壳呢？
Mama, why must we carry such a big and heavy shell every day?
妈妈就回答。
And the mama replied,
孩子啊。
Oh, my son.
因为我们的身体没有骨骼支撑。
Because there isn't any bone in our body to support our structure.
所以只能够爬。
We can only crawl and wriggle on the ground.
但我们爬的又不快。
And because we can't crawl very fast.
所以需要有一个壳来保护我们。
And so we need such a big heavy shell to protect us.
那为什么毛毛虫姐姐她也是爬，但是她不用背那么重的壳来保护她。
Then what about the caterpillar? She doesn't have any, she can't crawl very fast. Why doesn't she need such a heavy shell?
因为毛毛虫姐姐她会变成蝴蝶啊。
Because the caterpillar will one day transform into a butterfly.
她的翅膀就能够保护她了。
And then her wings will be able to protect her.
那蚯蚓弟弟呢？
What about the earthworm?
她也是爬。
It also crawls and wriggles on the ground.
但是她也不用背着那么重的壳啊。
And it doesn't have to carry such a heavy shell.
哦，因为蚯蚓弟弟她会钻地啊。
Well, it's because the earthworm knows how to dig underground.
所以土地会保护蚯蚓弟弟啊。
So the soil of the earth will protect it.
小蜗牛听了就哭了起来。
Upon hearing this, a little snail began to cry.
太不公平了。
This is so unfair.
我们每一天都要背那么重那么大的壳。
We have to carry such a big and heavy shell every day.
讨厌死了。
I really hate it.
抱怨是我们经常会听到看到的事。
Now, I'm sure complaint is something that is very often, and very common that we get to hear.
可能我们也常常在做。
Perhaps we ourselves also do it very often.
从小孩子到老年人都是非常熟练的这件事情。
From young kids to old people, to complain about something is something that we are so good at.
只要有东西不合我们的胃口或者不合我们的心意。
As long as something doesn't suit our taste or doesn't suit our will,
我们就会开始抱怨。
We will start to complain.
有人会抱怨他的学校。
Some complain about their school.
有人抱怨他的家庭。
Some complain about their families.
有人抱怨他的政府。
Some complain about their government.
有人抱怨他的教会。
Some complain about their church.
有人抱怨他的配偶。
Some complain about their spouse.
上帝的子民以色列人他们也是很厉害抱怨的。
Even the children of God, the Israelites, they were also very good at complaining.
他们一出埃及就开始在抱怨。
Once they left Egypt, they have been started to complain.
整个旷野都是他们抱怨的声音。
The whole wilderness was filled with the voices of their complaint.
所以今天我们要来看以色列人他们怎样不停的抱怨。
Today, let's take a look at this. How did the Israelites keep grumbling and complaining?
过去的几个星期
In the past few weeks,
我们看见以色列人他们在埃及地做奴隶几百年了
We have seen how the Israelites being enslaved on this land of Egypt for hundreds of years.
所以他们痛苦的在那边哀求
In great despair and anguish, they cry out to God.
上帝看见了他们的困境
God saw their difficulty.
就差派了摩西来拯救他们出埃及
And God sent Moses to lead them out of Egypt.
出了埃及不久过后
Before they left Egypt,before long,
Pharaoh 还是不死心
Pharaoh didn't give up.
所以他就派追兵去追赶以色列人
And so Pharaoh sent out armies to pursue the Israelites.
以色列人看见后面有追兵，哇，前面又有红海了
When the Israelites saw that behind them were the armies of Egyptians and right in front of them was the Red Sea,
在走投无路之下
when they had no other way to escape,
上帝就施行他的神迹。把红海分开。
God did a miracle. God divided the Red Sea.
以色列人就这样走过了那个红海。
And the Israelites walked across the Red Sea on dry land just like that.
而法老的追兵也追了上去。
When the army of the Egyptian came to the sea,
但全部却葬身在红海里面。
They were all flooded and all killed by the sea.
过了红海。
Once they crossed the Red Sea,
大概走到苏尔的这个旷野。
When they came to this place called Shur,
他们已经三天找不到水喝了。
Now they hadn't had any food for 3 days.
然后最后找到一个水源。
Finally, when they saw a water source,
那叫马拉。
It's called Mara.
但是那里的土地是碱性的。
And yet, because that land was alkaline,
所以水是带苦又带咸的
and so the water that there was actually bitter and salty,
不能喝
which means you couldn't drink it.
原本没有水喝
Now, at first they had no water.
然后现在找到水又不能喝
Finally, when they were able to find some water, and now they realized that the water was not drinkable.
众人开始抱怨了
And so the Israelites began to grumble.
他们对摩西说
They said this to Moses.
我们喝什么啊
What are we going to drink?
其实这是以色列人他们第二次抱怨了。
Actually, this was already the second time the Israelites complained to Moses.
第一次就是上个星期我们看到的。
Now, last week we saw how they complained for the first time.
他们要在过红海之前看见追兵，他们就害怕，就开始抱怨。
Before they crossed the Red Sea, they were terrified when they saw the Egyptians' army, and so they began to grumble.
那时他们抱怨摩西没有事，怎么要带他们出来
？That time they grumbled and complained to Moses. Why did Moses lead them out of Egypt?
啊，让他们死在旷野。
And Moses was going to let them all die in the wilderness.
然后这次就抱怨没有水喝。
And this time they were complaining about no water.
如果我们继续看经文
，If we were to continue to look at the Bible,
过了两个月，他们来到寻的旷野。
In another 2 months, when they come to this wilderness called Sin,
然后没有东西吃。
This time they were going to be out of food.
他们又在抱怨。
They were going to complain again.
然后解决了吃的问题，不久过后。
And once their food problem was solved,
在十七章我们又看到又没有水喝了，又在抱怨了。
In chapter 17, when the Israelites once again faced with water problem, they complained again.
为什么以色列人他们会一直在抱怨呢
？Why did the Israelites keep complaining?
首先就是他们忘恩。
First of all, they weren't grateful.
可能有人认为
Perhaps some people think that
呀正常啦
It is normal
没有几天没有水喝了
You have been out of water for many days
哦又没有东西吃
And you have no food
当然会抱怨啊
Definitely you will go complaining
那我们想想一下
And yet I want you to think about this
上帝用了十灾把以色列人拯救出来
God sent 10 plagues in order to save the Israelites out of the land of Egypt
然后他们也亲身经历看到红海怎样分开
，and the Israelites with their own eyes they witnessed how God divided the Red Sea for them.
他们经历了那么壮观、那么伟大的神迹。
Even after they had experienced and witnessed such a great miracle,
但是他们好像还没有什么感觉。
They still couldn't feel anything.
但一次忘恩不要紧了。
It is all right for them to be ungrateful for one time.
然后第二次没有水喝也是神迹。
And yet. When the second time they complained again because they had no water, God sent another miracle.
本来又咸又苦的水。
The water that was originally bitter and salty.
然后上帝吩咐摩西把一根树枝丢下去，那个水就变甜了。
God asked Moses to throw in a tree branch, and then the water was transformed into something sweet.
几个月后。
After a few months,
他们又忘记了这个水的这个神迹。
They forgot about the miracle of water again.
再次抱怨没有食物吃。
And they complained once again about having no food.
有人说
Some people said,
什么人都可以惹。
It's okay to bear with any kind of people.
但是饿肚子的人千万不好惹。
And yet, never ever trigger someone who is hungry.
这次全会众都吵了起来。
This time, the whole assembly were complaining.
想象一下。真三百多万的人同时在抱怨。
Just imagine about 3 million of people they are complaining at the same time.
那个情况是像是一个打仗的情况。
Definitely that situation would sound like a battle, a war going on.
所以上帝就很快有行动了。
So God immediately acted.
所以就让他们经历天上掉下玛纳和鹌鹑的神迹。
And so God sent another miracle. God sent the manna and also quail from heaven.
但过了不久后
And yet,
又在 complain 没有水喝了
Before long, the Israelites began to complain about having no water.
以色列人三番四次的不断的在抱怨
The Israelites, they kept complaining and complaining.
但上帝还是一次一次一次的在帮助他们
And yet God kept helping them once and another, again and again.
可以见得上帝对他们的宽容、容忍是多么的大。
We could see how generous, how forgiving God was towards them.
不过，上帝容忍他的子民是有原因的。
And yet, God has His own reason when He chooses to bear it and also to be forgiving with His children.
接下来我会讲到。
I will talk about that later.
弟兄姐妹。
Now, dear brothers and sisters.
上帝一直不断地帮助以色列人。
God was helping the Israelites all the time.
而且在拯救他们。
God was also rescuing them.
但他们却一直在忘记上帝的恩典。
And yet, again and again, the Israelites forgot about God's grace.
在这奥运的期间。
Now, during this Olympic time,
我们都会看到许多那些运动员的故事。
We have heard about many stories of the Olympic athletes.
有一个运动员，他叫 Nando Malango.
There was one athlete.By the name Ntando Malangu. He came from South Africa. He was actually the silver medalist of 2016 Rio Olympic Games. Though it was also an Olympic Games.
但是他是参加那个残疾人奥林匹克运动会。
And yet, the one that he participated was actually the Paralympics.
马兰古他从小就患有先天性的疾病。
Ever since young, Malangu was suffering from a natural disease.
他从小就坐在轮椅。
He had to sit on a wheelchair ever since young.
然后直到2012年他十岁的那一年。
Until the year 2012, when he was 10 years old.
有机构就赠送了他一对的义肢。
An NGO sent him some free, limbs.
他的人生才从此改变了。
Then only his life was changed forever.
他终于可以第一次走路了。
For the very first time, he was able to walk.
他最快乐的事情就是奔跑。
And the thing that makes him the happiest was to run.
每次他在奔跑的时候，都可以看到他的脸上都是充满笑容的。
Every time when he runs, he will smile the brightest.
他非常感谢赠送他义肢的机构。
And he's very grateful towards the NCO that gave him this gift.
他唯有用他在赛场上的成绩来报答他的感恩。
In order to show his gratitude, he actually uses the results on his sports events.To repay the NGO's kindness.
所以2016年是他第一次参加残奥会。
In 2016, it was his very first time to take part in the Paralympic.
然后他就在200米获得银牌。
And he won the silver medalist in 200 meter.
2019年
In year 2019,
他更是在世界残疾锦标赛获得金牌。
He won a gold medal in 2019 World Para-Athletics Championships.
他说他奔跑是为着那些跟他有一样遭遇的人而奔跑。
According to Ntando Malangu, he said that I run because I want to run for those who also suffer from the same destiny as I am.
他也帮助那些, 特别是没有脚的那些孩子。
He also helps those children, especially without legs.
同时也让他不断地记得当年那些机构如何帮助他。
And he has never ever forgotten about how those NGO has helped him.
弟兄姐妹,
Dear brothers and sisters,
以色列人他前前后后不到半年的时间,
The Israelites, within half a year,
他们就经历了四个那么奇妙的神迹,
They experienced four great miracles.
但是他们还是忘记那帮助他们的那位上帝。
And yet they still forgot about the God whom helped them.
这看起来好像很难理解。
It seemed something very hard for us to understand.
不过又是好像很熟悉,
and yet it also sounds quite familiar.
因为好像我们常常犯的一个毛病一样,
because it sounds like something that we often, a mistake that we often make.
在生活上有问题的时候,
when we have trouble in our life,
啊, 我们就来找上帝,
we will come and seek God.
当上帝帮助我们平步青云的时候,
after God has helped us and everything goes smooth sailing,
我们就开始把上帝丢进 storeroom里面,
then we would just keep our God in the storeroom.
可能连祷告都懒得祷告,
perhaps we will get too lazy to even pray.
然后有问题就开始抱怨上帝,
and yet when trouble comes again, we will start complaining to God.
我们想想看,
let us think about this.
我们是否还记得最近一次上帝如何帮助我们?
Do you still remember when was the most recent one when God helped us?
一般上忘恩的原因, 是因为他觉得那件事情是理所当然的。
Normally, people will be ungrateful when they take things for granted.
就他觉得是理所当然, 然后他就会开始抱怨。
They think that, oh, this is something that you should do for me, and so they began to complain.
最常见的就是我们在消费的时候。
Now, this is most commonly seen when we are consuming or when we are spending money.
我们在餐厅点了餐，很久都没有来。
After you have ordered food in the restaurant, when the food doesn't come for after a long time,
我们就会向服务员抱怨。
We will begin to complain to the waiter.
当我们去旅行, 一进到酒店的时候,
when you go on a holiday, once you step into the hotel,
哇,这样肮脏的,
you're so dirty.
然后我们就会向酒店抱怨,
and then you complain to the hotel management.
当我们去修理车的时候,
when you send your car for repair,
诶,拿到车, 发现那问题还是一样,
when you get back your car and you find that the same problem is still there,
我们就会开始抱怨,
and you will start to complain.
怎么做的啊?
My, what have you done?
我们会抱怨是因为我们觉得, 诶, customer always right.
We will complain because we think that customers are always right.
我们消费得不到应得的回报就会开始抱怨。
When we do not get what we deserve, we will begin to complain.
这个是很合理的。
Okay, this is quite logical.
但很多人在上帝的面前就是以为他是顾客。
And yet many people think that they are consumers when they are before God.
这样就会有问题了。
Then this is something not right.
而以色列人就是这样。
The same thing went with the Israelites.
没有食物吃的时候, 全会众就抱怨摩西。
When they had no food, the whole assembly complained to Moses.
他们对摩西说,
they said this to Moses.
我们早死在埃及地, 耶和华的手下好一点。 那时我们坐在肉锅旁边, 吃得饱足。 你将我们领出来, 到这个旷野, 是叫这全会众都饿死啊。
With that, we had died by the hand of the Lord in the land of Egypt, when we sat by the flesh pots and ate bread to the full. For you have brought us out into this wilderness to kill this whole assembly with hunger.
这个对白是不是很熟悉啊?
Now, don't you think that this line sounds familiar?
就是还没有过红海之前刚刚讲了一遍。
You know, they actually have said the same thing before they crossed the Red Sea.
更离谱的是第四次抱怨没有水喝的时候。
What is even more illogical or unreasonable is when they complain for the fourth time about having no food, no water. They even wanted to stone Moses.
以色列人他们会这样说,
the Israelites would say something like this. As if it was Moses who wanted to leave Egypt.
哦,
as if they didn't want to leave Egypt at all.
他们是很想留在埃及继续做奴隶。
As if they were so, they would be happier to stay on in Egypt and be slaves.
但回头看,
and yet, if we are to look back,
苦苦哀求。
Who are the one who cry out in despair?
然后说他们在埃及被欺压得很辛苦。
Who are the one who complained that they had been enslaved and they were being persecuted and being very hard pressed in Egypt?
就是他们自己啊。
It was the Israelites themselves.
然后现在就怪摩西没有事找事做。
And yet now they blame Moses and said that Moses did all this.For no reason.
那出埃及是你要的。
You are the one who wanted to leave Egypt.
不是我们要的。
We didn't want it.
现在没有水，没有食物吃。
Now we have no food, no water.
快快搞定它。
You better settle all this.
他们一直都认为，诶，是摩西的错。
They kept thinking that all these were actually the fault of Moses.
所以他们觉得我有权利抱怨。
And so they thought that they had the right to complain.
上帝的神迹和恩典对他们来说就是理所当然的。
The miracles and also grace of God to them, they thought they were supposed to be like that.
如果你是摩西的话，
If you were Moses,
你会有什么反应？
What would you do?
如果是我的话，
If I were Moses,
我早就不理他们了。
I would just left them and ignored them.
理得他们饿死渴死。
I wouldn't bother whether they would die out of hunger or die out of thirst.
但摩西就是一个很好的领袖。
And yet Moses was such a good leader.
他虽然在面对这些很刁蛮的以色列人，
Though he was faced with Israelites that were so hard to get along,
他还是愿意带领他们。
He was still willing to lead them.
还是愿意向上帝求，哦，他们没有食物吃，没有水喝了，怎么办？
He was still willing to cry out to God for their sake.
弟兄姐妹，
Dear brothers and sisters,
面对这个疫情，
While we are facing with this pandemic,
我们有没有在抱怨上帝？
Have we been complaining to God?
那都是你的错啦。
It's all your fault, God.
为什么要让这个病毒出现？
Why did you let this virus come here?
要搞到我们那么惨。
Now we all are living in misery.
搞到我没有工作做。
Now I'm out of job.
搞到身边的人都离开了。
Many of my loved ones, my families have left.
搞到我没有得去旅行。
Now I can't go on any holiday.
现在要出去吃饭都不可以。
I can't even go out and dine at the restaurant.
搞到我困在家里就要困死了。
You know, you are the one who should be blamed. Now I have to stay at home all the time.
都是你的错，上帝。
It's all your fault, God.
我们有没有抱怨过？
Have we been complained?
如果有的话，
Have we been complaining? If we have,
我们要问问自己。
Then we have to ask ourselves,
我在上帝的面前，我到底是谁？
Who am I when I come before God?
我是上帝的顾客吗？
Am I God's consumer?
我是来跟上帝消费的吗？
Do I come here to pay money to God and ask for his service?
还是他是我们的救主？
Or is God our savior?
我们是他的儿女。
And we are his children.
如果我们看他就是我们的上帝，
If we see God as our God,
我们就不会把他在我们身上做的事情当成是理所当然。
Then we will not take all the wonderful blessings that God has sent us as granted, as something granted.
反而我们会看见我们现在的处境还有感谢他的理由。
Instead, when we look around us, we will be filled with a thankful heart.
第三，
Thirdly,
就是婴孩的灵性。
A baby state of spiritual life.
从以色列人他们开始抱怨。
Ever since the very beginning, when they started to complain,
他们都是一直在向摩西抱怨。
The Israelites had been complaining towards Moses.
都是一直认为是摩西的错。
They always thought that it was Moses' fault.
你要为这件事情负责任。
Moses, you have to take responsibility for this.
却不晓得背后其实是上帝在带领他们出埃及的。
Little did they realize that it was actually God who led them out of Egypt.
是上帝一直在帮助他们，拯救他们。
It was God who had been helping them and rescuing them.
其实他们会这样的想法其实不难理解的。
Now, it is not very hard for us to understand why would they have such a thinking.
因为他们大部分的人其实都不认识上帝。
Because most of them didn't know God.
从上帝拣选亚伯拉罕，
Ever since God chose Abraham,
然后到雅各，到约瑟，
till Jacob, till Joseph,
其实那个信仰是刚起步而已。
We could say that the faith was just at its budding stage.
虽然上帝是称为以色列人的神，
Though God was being called as the God of Israelites,
但以色列人他们400多年在埃及，
And yet, don't forget that For about 400 years, the Israelites were enslaved in Egypt.
然后他们过后变为奴隶了。
They were slaves there.
上帝也没有什么很明显的作为。
And God didn't show any very obvious particular miracles among them.
所以他们以色列人对上帝的这个印象是很模糊的。
And so, no wonder the Israelites had a very blurred vision towards God.
这样我们就会明白出埃及记十五章二十四、二十五节，上帝说。
And so we could understand why in chapter 15 of Exodus verse 24 to 25, God said that
上帝说要试验他们。
God wanted to test them.
每当上帝试验人的时候，就是要考验我们对他的这个信靠。
Whenever God wants to test a person, God wants to see how faithful and how much we trust in him.
因为上帝知道以色列人他们信心的程度是去到哪里。
Because God knew very well how much the Israelites trust in him.
所以他才吩咐摩西要告诉会众要听上帝的话。
And so God told Moses to tell the Israelites to listen and to obey to God's word.
去做上帝吩咐他们做的事情。
To go and do the things that instructed by God.
不过在旷野旷野百姓还是学不会。
And yet in this wilderness of sin, the Israelites couldn't learn their lesson.
他们向摩西抱怨。
They complained toward Moses.
所以摩西就没大喊了。
And so Moses couldn't bear it any longer.
就对他们说。
Moses said this to them.
我们算什么？
What are we?
你们的怨言不是向我们发的，乃是向耶和华发的。
Your murmurings are not against us, but against the Lord.
就是说关我什么事啊？
Which means, what does it have to do with us?
诶，我只是打工罢了
嘞。I'm only an employee.
那个真正的是耶和华。
The real employer was God Jehovah himself.
所以你们现在 complain 是 complain 他嘞。
When you complain, you're actually complaining against him.
接下来摩西再次强调，你们为什么与我争闹？为什么试探耶和华呢？
And so Moses kept on emphasizing on this. Why did you find fault with me? Why did you find fault with God?
为什么？
Why?
因为他们的信心就像 baby 这样。
For the Israelites only had baby level faith.
因为 baby 最擅长做的事情是什么？
Because what is a baby best at?
就是哭闹咯。
Which is to cry and to complain.
当 baby 哭闹的时候，
When a baby cries,
可能就是他大便了。
Maybe because he had just pooped.
或者他肚子饿，
or maybe he's hungry，
或者可能很热睡不到，
or maybe it's too hot the baby can't fall asleep，
所以父母就要尽可能满足 baby 的需要，
and so the parents would try their best to satisfy the need of the baby，
然后这样他才不会再哭，
then only the baby would stop crying。
以色列人他们一遇到问题就哭闹，
once the Israelites were faced with problem they would start to cry and to complain，
他们甚至连抱怨的对象都搞不清楚，
they had evenmade the wrong subject of their complaints.
可能很多时候我们也是这样。
Perhaps many a time we are also like that.
一面对到不顺利的时候。
Once we are faced with something that is not what we have been asking for,
然后就开始埋怨上帝。
We will begin to complain to God.
祷告没有用的。
No use for me to pray.
都好像没有听呢。
God, you're not listening.
这种事情都会发生在我身上。
Why would such a thing happen to me?
还讲祝福我，看顾我。
God, you're the one who said you want to bless me, you want to guard me.
是你要我这样做，然后现在就不要理我。
God, you wanted me to do this at first, and now you just ignored me.
到底想要怎样？
God, what do you want?
我相信我们都有向上帝抱怨过。
I'm sure all of us more or less have complained towards God.
不是说我们不可以抱怨。
I'm not saying that we can't complain.
但是我们的灵性，我们对上帝的信心需要成长。
And yet, I'm trying to tell you that our spiritual life and also our faith in God need to grow.
如果十年前我们这样抱怨，
If 10 years ago you were complaining about one matter,
十年后还是为着同件事情在抱怨，
And yet 10 years later you are still complaining over the same matter,
那我们就要好好检讨自己的属灵生命。
Then we really need to examine our spiritual life.
我们看到上帝是允许百姓在抱怨。
We could see that God allowed His own people to complain.
然后他就一直在给他们时间，给他们机会成长。
God kept giving them time and also chances for them to grow.
同样的，今天上帝也是给我们机会，给我们时间在成长。
Likewise, today God is also giving us ample time and also chances to grow.
但我们不要得寸进尺。
And yet, let us not ask too much from God.
不要轻看上帝的恩典和忍耐。
Let us not despise God's grace and also God's patience.
因为我们继续看下去的话，
because if we are to continue to look at the future chapters,
后来上帝对以色列人的抱怨真的来到忍无可忍。
There was one point where God really couldn't stand the complaint from the Israelites anymore.
所以他就惩罚那些从头到尾都一直抱怨的人。
And so God punished those who had been complaining all this while.
这些人通通都不可以进迦南地。
None of them could enter the land of Canaan.
所以他们全部这些整天抱怨的人都死在旷野。
And so all of them who had been complaining all this while, they all died in the wilderness.
以色列人他们不停抱怨。给我们学习什么功课呢？
What lessons can we learn from the Israelites from their way of keep on complaining?
首先就是不要忘恩。
First of all, let us not be ungrateful.
我们就要提醒自己，要常常记得上帝对我的恩惠。
We have to remind ourselves and to so that we can remember God's grace all the time.
当事情发生的时候，
when something bad happens,
我们要想到哦，上帝的恩典是够我们用的。
We have to remind ourselves that God's grace is sufficient for us.
这样就不会把他的恩典当作是理所当然。
Then we will not take God's grace for granted.
因为他是我们的上帝。
For He is our God.
主耶稣是我们的救主。
Lord Jesus is our Savior.
我们不是他的顾客。
We are not His consumers.
我们不是来跟他消费的。
We are not here to pay money and ask for His service.
我们是他的儿女，同时也是仆人。
We are his children, and at the same time, we are his servants.
他时时刻刻都会不断地在帮助我们，与我们同在。
God will help us all the time. God is with us all the time.
然后我们也要提醒自己。
Yet we must also remind ourselves.
我们的灵性不要一直在 baby 的阶段。
Let us not stay at this baby level, baby stage of faith all the time.
我们对神的信心要不断地成长。
Our faith in God must grow.
要更认识上帝。
We must know more of God.
这样我们才能够明白神的心意。
Then only we will understand God's will.
去做合他心意的事情。
Then only we'll able to do things that please Him.
我们就不会那么容易对事情感到不满。
And so we will be less unsatisfied toward things.
反而更能够在困境中看见哦，神还有恩典。
On the other hand, we're able to see God's grace everywhere, even in difficulties.
这样我们的生命才会充满。
Then only we will be filled with God's joy.
最后要跟大家分享我的一个经历。
Finally, I would like to share with you one of my stories.
记得有一次我跟师母去金马伦要参加一个退休会。
I remember there was once my wife and I we wanted to go to Cameron Highlands to attend a retreat camp.
刚出发的时候。
When we were about to embark on our journey,
我和师母就在车上祷告。
So my wife and I, we prayed in the car.
因为早上的时候我们才听到缅甸有一个姐妹因为发生车祸而去世了。
Because on that very morning, we have heard the news about a sister in Myanmar passed away in a car accident.
所以我就叫师母要祷告到仔细一点。
And so I asked my wife to pray more detailed.
所以师母就做了一个蛮长的一个祷告。
So my wife prayed a rather long prayer.
其中有一段说到。
So halfway through, my wife said this.
上帝不管发生什么事情，
God, no matter what happens,
我们都相信你有你的旨意在当中。
We believe that you have your will in us.
在路上我们就很开心的在聊天。
So we were talking happily all the way.
然后也一面在唱诗。
And we were also singing hymns together.
在过一个弯的时候。
While we were about to turn a corner,
突然间看见前面的车。停下来了。
Suddenly, I saw that the car in front of me stopped.
然后左右又有车。
And there were also cars right beside me.
不能够闪。
There's no way for me to go anywhere.
所以我只能够急停。
All I could do was to take an emergency brake.
当时刚下过雨。
Because it had been raining just now,
然后路还很滑。
So the road was very slippery.
又是斜坡。
And we were actually on a slope.
虽然我踩完了那个刹车。
Even though I tried my best and I pressed the brake,
但是那个车还是停不下来。
And yet I still failed to fully stop the car.
不到三秒钟就
砰。Within 3 seconds, our car crashed onto the car in front of us.
前面被我撞的那辆车被我撞到另外一个分叉路口去。
So the car in front of me was actually being hit until it, that car itself went to another lane.
为什么前面的车会停下来呢？
Why would that car suddenly stopped?
其实它是第二辆车来的。
Actually, that car was the second car.
第一辆停在前面的是因为他看见有一个就摩托司机他滑倒在路上。
The first car stopped because he saw a motorcyclist slipped and were falling on the ground on the road.
他就停下车去扶。
And so the first driver actually stopped his car and went down from his car to go and help the motorcyclist.
然后第二辆车他停了下来。
And so the second car stopped just on time.
我是第三辆，我停不下来。
I was the third driver. I couldn't stop my car.
又这样撞上去。
And that's how our cars collided.
可能我可以抱怨上帝。
Perhaps I could complain to God.
上帝有没有搞错？
God, are you sure? Are you kidding me?
刚才跟你祷告。
We've just prayed to you.
而且现在我们是要去参加退休会。
And you know what? God, we are now on our way to a retreat camp.
好不容易有放假的时间。
Such a golden opportunity for us to have a holiday.
到几分钟你就让我撞上去。
Just within a few minutes, now we had a car accident.
你的保守在哪里？
Where is your protection, God?
你的平安在哪里？
Where is your peace, oh God?
还要我人生第一次撞车。
And that was also my very first car accident in my life.
上帝，你是不是在开玩笑？
God, are you kidding me?
我们的内心会有这样的抱怨可能是很正常的。
Well, it is something very normal for us to complain.
但是我和师母却没有抱怨。
And yet, my wife and I, we didn't complain at all.
撞了过后我们就看、哎、有没有事情。
So I was actually busy checking whether any of us were injured.
感谢主我没有事情。
Thank God, I'm fine.
然后师母的脚只是顶到那个车座有一点黑青而已。
And my wife's leg got a little bit of bruises.
当然车就不能够再驾了。
But that car was suffered from a great damage.
不过我们的心是充满感恩的。
And yet our hearts were filled with thanksgiving.
我就对师母说。
So I said this to my wife.
哎呀，我们去不成啊。
Oh, we can't go to the retreat camp anymore.
这样晚上我们去庆祝一下咯。
So why don't we go and celebrate tonight?
然后过后我就跟我爸爸借了车。
And later on, I borrowed a car from my father.
晚上我们就去吃了我们最喜欢吃的日本餐。
So that night, we went to have our favorite meal, a Japanese meal.
过后我们还是决定、啊、第二天我们还是去那个退休会吧。
And later on, we decided that we still wanted to go to that retreat camp.
然后第二天我们再驾着我爸爸的车去退休会了。
So the following day, we used our father's car and continued our journey to that retreat camp.
当然了，整个的退休会都是很喜乐的。
And of course, the whole camp was very joyful.
所以弟兄姐妹
，So dear brothers and sisters,
盼望我们在面对任何的困境的时候
，I really pray that no matter in what kind of plight or difficult situation you are in,
我们可以学习有不同的眼光。
We are able to learn to see things with a different eye.
首先要先停止抱怨。
First of all, we have to stop complaining.
特别是我们在这个疫情中。
Especially when we are now in the midst of pandemic.
让我们能够看见主还有恩典在我的身上。
Let us see that God still have grace, still have enough and sufficient grace in my life.
当我们这样看的时候。
When we are to see things with such a perspective.
我们就能够知道我们身为上帝的儿女是何等的蒙福的。
We will realize how blessed we are as children of God.
我们同心祷告。
Let us pray in one heart.
主，我们感谢你。
Lord, we thank you.
虽然身为你的儿女。
As children, your children.
但我们在生活上我们没有任何的特权。
Yet we don't have any special privileges in life.
我们还是会生病。
We still fall sick.
可能我们还是会被病毒感染。
Sometimes, some of us might even get infected by this COVID virus.
可能我们还是没有工作做。
Perhaps some of us are still out of job.
但是就是在这些困境中，你就是要让我们看见你的奇妙。
And yet, it is through these difficult situations you want us to see how wonderful you are.
求你帮助我们。
Help us, God.
今天透过以色列人的经历
Through the experience of Israelites
让我们学习我们不要再抱怨
Help us to learn to stop complaining
因为我们知道你一定会在我们的沙漠中开江河给我们
For we know that you definitely will will open a river in the midst of the wilderness for us.
你每次都在提醒我们，就是要让我们知道你就是耶和华。
God, you have been reminding us all this time that you are our God, Jehovah.
求你让我们有不同的眼光。
Grant us a different perspective.
能够借着这样的一些困境来更认识你。
Through difficult situations, we're able to know more of your grace.
求你让我们不要忘恩。
Help us not to be ungrateful.
不要把你的恩典当作是理所当然的。
Help us not to take your grace for granted.
也不要永远都一直在被逼的阶段。
Help us not to stay always stagnant in our spiritual life.
求你的话语改变我们。
May your word come and transform us.
垂听祷告。
Listen to our prayer.
奉主耶稣基督的名。
In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
弟兄姐妹。
Dear brothers and sisters.
如果要抱怨。
If we are to complain.
有千千万万的事情我们可以去抱怨。
There are thousands and thousands of things for us to complain about.
若我们仔细去想。
If we are to think carefully.
其实有更多我们可以感谢上帝的事情。
There are actually more things for us to give thanks to God for.
Amen.
Amen.
是你永远最爱宝贝、
让我们用主导文来祷告。
Let us now pray the Lord's Prayer.
我们在天上的父，愿人都尊你的名为圣，愿你的国降临，愿你的旨意行在地上，如同行在天上。我们日用的饮食，今日赐给我们，免我们的债，如同我们免了人的债，不叫我们遇见试探，救我们脱离凶恶，因为国度、权柄、荣耀全是你的，直到永远。阿们。以下是一些报告及代祷的事项。
Now we have a few announcements and also some prayer items.
首先
First of all,
总会的凯盛儿童之家他们芥菜种的计划。
About the mustard seed plan for the Kaizen Children's Home.
主要是帮助儿童之家里面七个的小朋友。
This plan is to support the seven children in the Kaizen Children's Home.
就是供应他们日常的经费
to support their daily expenses.
一年是240块
The yearly subscription is 240 ringgit.
所以一个月只需要奉献20块
Which means you only need to offer 20 ringgit every month.
目前只有百多个人奉献而已
So far, there are only a few hundred members who have participated in this plan.
他们的目标是希望有300个人奉献
Now,Our target is to have 300 members to take part in this mustard seed plan.
再次呼吁有能力的弟兄姐妹。
Once again, I would like to urge all brothers and sisters who are capable.
可以给予儿童之家一点的帮助。
Kindly give a helping hand to the children of Kaizen's Children's Home.
有感动奉献的弟兄姐妹。
Those who are willing to offer.
你们可以直接奉献到那个银行户口或者联络相关的负责人。
You may directly offer your money to the bank account mentioned, or you may contact the person in charge.
这个星期我们还是可以带着感恩的心，透过网上过账奉献给上帝。
This week, all of us are able to do our money offering with a thankful heart using online transfer again.
还是一样，请大家注明，然后把你们的收据发给教会的财政。
As usual, remember to send your bank statement to our church treasurer and also state clearly which item you're offering.
愿上帝赐福凡甘心乐意奉献的弟兄姐妹。
May God bless those who offer willingly and cheerfully.
其他的报告请大家自行去看教会的周讯。
For other announcements, kindly refer to the church bulletin.
以下是一些代祷的事项。
Now we have a few prayer items.
首先我们为着我们国家的政治来祷告
First of all, let us pray for the politics in Malaysia
求主怜悯我们的国家
May God have mercy on our country
国家的政治动荡不安
Our political situation hasn't been stable
这会让我国的疫情面临更危险的情况
This actually will cause a pandemic to become worse
求主怜悯和带领
May God have mercy on Malaysia, may God come and lead Malaysia
求主为我国开一条路。
May God open a way for us.
第二项。
Secondly,
我们要为着陈格安弟兄来祷告。
Let us continue to pray for Brother Jason Tan.
感谢主 ，Jason 弟兄已经从 ICU 转到普通病房了。
We thank God that he has been transferred from the ICU to a normal ward.
目前还需要氧气的辅助。
At the moment, he still needs this oxygen supply.
请弟兄姐妹继续的为他来祷告。
Let us all continue to pray for him.
求主医治他，让他能够完全的康复起来。
May God heal him so that he may be healed thoroughly.
第三项。
Thirdly,
为着弟兄姐妹的生命祷告。
Let us pray for the life of all brothers and sisters.
在长期行动受限制的情况下。
After such a long time of having our movement being restricted,
可能有许多人开始出现了苦闷和焦虑的症状。
I'm sure some of us have started to feel depressed or to feel anxious.
求主帮助大家。
May God help all of us.
在这样的情况下，依然能够把 眼目定睛在主的身上。
To continue to focus on the Lord even under such a difficult situation.
让我们不忘了主托付我们的使命。
Let us not forget about the mission that God has assigned us.
无时无刻都能够为他做美好的见证。
May God help us to always bear witness for him.
最后，让我们来领受上帝的赐福。
Now let us receive God's blessing.
May the Lord bless you and keep you.The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. 我愿主赐福于你，保护你。愿主用他面上的荣光照你，赐恩于你。愿主眷顾你，赐你平康。奉圣父、圣子、圣灵的名。 Amen.